I'm Bill Dean with Temple Fire and Rescue, driver with the department, Temple, Texas. I just wanted to go over our new platform that we're specking out here at Pierce in Wisconsin. This will be a downtown truck. We are an 8-station department, ALS, first responder department, all trucks and engines and squads. So I'm going to go over a few of the features we've done with this truck. I'll go ahead and start here on the front. We've done this on a previous truck also. We have two hose lays in the front that can be deployed from either side. Typically we run 150 and 200. These are foam. And this raises up for ease of loading when you're done with the fire. And once again, these will hold, both hold 200, but we load 150, 200 here. This is a nice feature we like because you can swing it out of the way while you're reloading hose. Going to the truck, we went to the Velocity cab. We have another Velocity. We like them real well. We like the red interior with the black. Everything's fairly basic as far as a regular platform. We run the pan doors on the side here. This is an ALS truck. There will be always at least one paramedic on it. So we have compartments that are going to be louvered in the back. When we get to the other side, I'll show you the AC unit. We have an auxiliary AC unit. In the back, we have the long cab. There's our interior auxiliary AC unit, which we run because we are ALS. We do keep medications on the truck. And being in our area in the summertime, temperatures can reach 100 degrees. Obviously, we have to keep those medications cool. So having an auxiliary AC that runs not only makes it more comfortable to get in the truck after it's been sitting, but it keeps the medications cool and we don't have to carry the medications in and out after every call and keep them in the station. We added this to keep ladders, backboards, tarps, so on and so forth on each side. Just a kind of a handy area. It really doesn't add any length to the truck, but it gives you some compartment space. Husky 3 foam system, another two cross lays, which will hold 200 foot apiece. We go with all with the wheel discharges. We have a total of 7 foam discharges with the Husky system on here. It's got compartments up here that we added that we like just for extra stuff. The other side, it's a cord reel. Driver's compartment, place for him to stow his stuff, and then all of our couplings and so on and so forth will be kept in here. Pike poles, axes can be stored here. Swings out, that's a nice feature that we have. We've also have this on another truck. Full scene lighting down the side. Lights up an area really nice. Also on the cab, we have them. This compartment will keep our foam, extra foam buckets and stuff for the foam system. 500 gallons of water and 30 gallons of foam on the truck, 30-gallon foam cell. Going to the back, being this is a Quint-type apparatus, 300 feet and 300 feet, one will be 2 1/4 inch and one will be 3 inch. One will be fixed with a smoothbore hand nozzle and one will be fixed with a Blitzfire-style monitor. We have these on another truck. They work really well. Also, we can actually hold a full, this hose lay we have back here, we can do a full 1,000 feet of 5-inch hose. We'll hold, and that's a nice feature. We've kind of a one-of-a-kind design on that we came up with. And then back here, just more compartments. Our fan will go in there. We have got to where we don't carry gas fans as much anymore. We carry electric fans, positive pressure fans. So we have a cord rail hooked to our generator, a 6 kW generator, and that way we can run fans or anything, positive pressure fans, anything we want to run, and easily deployed. And another compartment, like I showed you earlier on the other side, will hold backboards, extra tarps. We do keep a red line also right there, and for small fires, all salvage overhaul type situations at structure fires. Moving over here again, just another pan door. We keep a 12 lead monitor. And again, these are air conditioned. The cab is air conditioned, even when the truck's just sitting in the station. As long as the shoreline's hooked up, you can run air conditioning or heat inside the truck. Nice feature, especially in the summertime where it gets really hot. We did go with the extra large, extra wide bucket. We like it. It really doesn't take up much more room, and just a ton of room inside to work with. Also have room to hang your ladder belts and stuff and not bump into each other. So we've been really impressed so far with it. Extra lighting, scene lighting underneath, scene lighting on top, which will actually operate off of the 12 volt system to light up scenes when you're not using the ladder. Thank you for joining me going over our new truck. We're real happy with it, and we'd like to thank the citizens of Temple for approving us purchasing this truck. Thank you for your time.